scourge who stalks the innocent and destroys my robot allies always means to save lives. This scourge
cares for nothing. Like one of the rest devils. What are you doing here?
Devils do to you.
They felt that by keeping my head online would prove useful to them. Fortunately for me, they're stupid enough to actually believe anything I say. Admittedly, it hasn't gotten me very far, but it has saved me from the same fate as my rather unfortunate comrades you see in pieces around you. Now, back to my original question. What are you doing here?
Hunting down a radar beacon.
A radar beacon? How very interesting. That's a very specific part to be searching for. And you don't look like the typical part scavenger type to me. I calculate a 98.8% chance that you're looking for the mechanist. If I'm correct, and I usually am, then perhaps we can help each other with our respective predicaments. How refreshing. Then allow me to explain. Now, how can I put this as simple as possible so someone at your processing speed can understand? In order to find the mechanist, you're going to need more than just my radar beacon. You're going to need access to the facility. I'm willing to provide said access, but you'll have to fulfill two simple conditions. One, you need to get me as far away as you can from these lunatics. And two, find me a new body. Once both conditions are satisfied, I'll gladly provide you with everything you need. Do we have a deal?
How do I know you'll keep up your end of the bargain?
Even though there's a human brain floating in a biogel inside my head, I'm still bound by my original programming. It pains me to admit it, but one of my directives states that I cannot lie. Ever. So, while I'm not the most charming robot you've ever encountered, the last thing I'm going to do is violate an agreement we've made. Now that we have that out of the way, do we have a deal?
Deal.
A wise decision. Once we're at our destination, I'll happily relinquish my radar beacon as a gesture of good faith. Now, I strongly suggest you stop loitering in the middle of a hostile location and get us both out of here at once.
Come to warn you of the scourge who stalks the innocent and destroys my robot allies. I come to warn you of a new scourge who stalks the innocent and destroys my robot allies, only seems to save lives. This scourge cares nothing for the progress we have made, but we will find him and bring him to justice. People of the Commonwealth, it is I, the Mechanist. You of a new scourge who stalks the innocent and destroys my robot allies. Only seeks to save lives. This scourge carries something for the progress we have made, but we will find him and bring him to justice. People of the Commonwealth, it is I, the Mechanist.
Things seem to be
bad. I come to warn you of a new scourge who stalks the innocent and destroys my robot allies. Only seeks to save lives. This scourge cares nothing for the progress we have made. We will find him and bring him to justice.
Everything is bombed. Enforcement
on the Commonwealth. It is I, the Mechanist. I come to warn you of a new scourge who stalks the innocent and destroys my robot allies. Only seems to save lives. This scourge cares nothing for the progress we have made.
The tripwires. I'd rather keep myself intact today, thank you. Let's take a look at what you've got. resistance here, aren't you?
Area secure.
Hostile.
negative experience with you. I estimate a 65% chance of making it out of here. Not optimal. An increase in effort could have an impact on the odds. The one that ripped my head off. I demand we rip her head off. It's only fair.
Thank you.
heads up.
Sure. Go ahead and take a look.
Heads up.
I'd be happy to help.
Get that rifle. Take that weapon.
I'll get it done.
Hey.
Yes, sir.
Grab that.
I'll take care of it.
Get that.
No problem.
Thank goodness we are out of that hole. Don't think your job is done. I refuse to cooperate until you provide a body that meets my standards.
you had anything worth taking.
Certainly.
Grab anything useful.
I'll take care of it.
Check it out.
No problem.
See if there's anything there. Glad to help out.
I can't argue with your timing. Who knows what would have happened to us if you hadn't been here. Thanks for your help, Mal.
I didn't want you to have all the fun.
If that's what you call fun, I'm glad you're on our side.
Thanks for your help fighting them off.
I hate raiders. I kill them every chance I get.
I'm glad you're on our side.
Alive.
Happy to help if I can.
Never fear, sir. I will ensure your safety to the best of my ability. It's a pleasure to serve with you, sir. I wasn't aware of them roaming the Commonwealth. Thank you.
Here you go, Ada. The final radar beacon. I'll need that head back when you're done.
Of course. Shouldn't take but a moment. There you go. Still in one piece. I'm not sure why you want the head back. All we needed was its radar beacon. Besides, robo-brains are notorious for being, well, a real pain in the neck.
What else do you know about them, Ada?
Quite simply, it's the first time General Atomics produced a successful union between organic matter and robotics. The brain is used both as a control unit and a data storage unit, which is far more efficient than using standard circuits. Unfortunately, there were a lot of programming issues with these robots, which caused them to be a bit, shall we say, unhinged. Hopefully, this particular robo-brain will have some of the answers that we've been seeking.
A union of organic matter and robotics? Sounds an awful lot like a synth.
Not at all. The robo-brain was built with a very different design philosophy in mind. General Atomics' intent was to use the human brain to augment the robot's functions, primarily to accelerate the decision-making process. Free thought and individuality was never intended. These were expressly built like soldiers, to follow orders without question. The robo-brain's unfortunate tendency towards violence and aggression should be considered more of a malfunction than a calculated decision.
We still need it, Ada. I believe it can help us access the Mechanist's facility.
Of course. It makes perfect sense that the Mechanist would not only keep its location a closely guarded secret, but would secure it against intrusion as well. I'm terribly sorry. I hadn't considered that possibility at all. I'm afraid when it comes to assisting humans, I'm not doing very well lately.
Don't be ridiculous. If it wasn't for you, we couldn't have gotten this far already.
That's kind of you to say. Ever since I let my friends die in that caravan, I feel like I've been failing in my duties. I chose the route we took the day we were attacked. Perhaps if I'd selected an alternate route, they'd still be alive. Sometimes I wish that Jackson had programmed me with my personality mode set permanently to disabled.
Your personality defines you as an individual. Never let that go.
You're right. All of the good memories I've experienced being Ada would be lost if my personality mode was shut down. I can't afford to lose them. I really think I needed to hear that from someone else. Thank you. Now I've distracted you for long enough. I'll finish up my calculations while you deal with our new friend, Jezebel. Hopefully, she'll be able to grant us access to the Mechanist's facility and we can put an end to this nonsense once and for all.
World's always gonna have tyrants.
Dust-proof, radiation-proof, and a lifetime supply of power. I couldn't ask for more. My systems are continuing to function at peak efficiency. much ahead to discover.